Hey, it's Plain Not Jane, and I'm here with this week's 7. Number 1 is everybody needs support. If you know someone that is starting something new, a new business, a new family, a new chapter in their lives, someone that's finishing something, somebody that's just doing something, even if they're just blinking, everybody needs support. So make sure that you're making yourself available to the people that you care about. Number 2, dos. Time flies. Yeah, check that out. Time flies. We really don't have as much time as any of us wish we had, or as much time as many of us think we have. So make sure that you're spending your time on the things and with the people that matter the most. Just be happy and be with those who celebrate you. Number 3, un, deux, trois, un, deux, trois. DIY can be challenging, but two things that I found to really be the challenges. One, I have no clue what I'm doing with these projects. Just about everything that I've done in the last couple of weeks has been the first time that I've done any of it. And two, tools. I'm finding that the right tool for the job really makes a huge difference. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, my Spanish sucks, and 2, 3, 4. I am one of those women that suffers from postpartum hair loss. So right now, this little puff that is atop my crown is my pride and joy right now. I'm just going to be real about it. I'm just so excited that I have hair again. Number 5, this past week, I went to visit my parents, and my dad and I, we were standing in the yard, and I heard this motor, you know, passing by. I looked around, and this guy was on a bike. He took a little motor and put it on the back wheel of his bike tire so that it would spin without him pedaling. It was the weirdest thing I saw all week, but also the coolest thing that I've seen in quite a while. I want one. Number 6. Number 6. My melamine sponges came in this week. Took about a month for them to get here. But it's 100 of them. Like, who doesn't get excited about 100 cleaning sponges? I'll probably order again. I'm excited about those sponges. Number 7. I have a 2-year-old. We call him Young Mountain, YM for short. YM tells everybody no. He even tells his sister no. Why do 2-year-olds say no so often? You can ask this guy anything, and the answer is no. Hey, YM, you want a granola bar? If he wants it, he'll just come take it. But if he doesn't, no. Are you ready for your nap? Do you want $1,000? Hey, you want to go chase down an ice cream truck? I don't know why 2-year-olds say no, but there's a lesson to be learned. Some adults need to learn to say no. Don't overextend yourself. It's okay to tell people no. So take a lesson from my YM and just tell people no, no, no. And that's been this week's 7. Don't forget to thumbs up this video if you liked it. Thumbs up if you liked it. And don't forget to click the button below to subscribe to my channel. If you like food, fun, family, and foolery, then this is the place to be. So click that subscribe button down there. Find me on Instagram at plain_not_Jane. Find me on Instagram, and don't forget to click subscribe. Yeah. All right. See you next time.